Hello! In last video, we talked about the FIB programming speed on NCS5500 and we picked a line card with Jericho Plus with external TCAM. In the blog post comment section, we got this question, wondering what the FIB programming speed is the other way for the 5501-24H, as it doesn't have an external TCAM. Maybe it's faster? Let's try to answer this one. First, a quick reminder on the key components of an NCS5500. We have Jericho and Jericho Plus ASICs, and FE3600 to interconnect them. The 5501-24H uses two Jericho Plus ASICs back-to-back, no external TCAM, no FE3600. We have two types of Jericho Plus ASICs in our products, and the big difference between them is the LPM database size. In this 24H router, we use the largest version that can handle more than 1.5 million V4 routes. So we have two databases, here LPM and LEM, and we will sort routes in one or the other depending on the prefix length. For our demo, we will reuse the same testbed, but this time the routes will be injected from the 5508 to the 24H. Let's check the router first. We verify we have a BGP session in active state because it's admin down on the other side. Victor built us another Grafana dashboard and we can measure BGP routes in RP and entries in LPM and LEM in real time. For this test, we run IOSXR 651. Okay, let's get started. On the 5508, we remove the shutdown config from the BGP peer. The BGP is now established. We will restart receiving the routes on the 24H. It's reflected via telemetry every second. Now that all the routes have been received on the system of the test, we can check the prefix distribution between LEM and LPM. And we can see that it's more or less half and half for the internet table. Using telemetry for this test is convenient because it gives a very graphical view of the programming speed. We start receiving routes at 23:49 and we have everything programmed at 24:20. That's 31 seconds later. Quick math, it's 24K prefixes per second in LEM and LPM. Also, for the BGP route in the route processor, we got everything at 23:59, that's 10 seconds after the beginning. So it's 75,000 prefixes per second. Like we did last time, we measure prefix withdrawal speed 2 simply by shutting down the session from the neighbor. We measure 26 seconds to flush all the routes, which represents almost 29K prefixes per second. To conclude, here are the results of the programming speed for TCAM and internal memories. It showed that TCAM is actually slightly faster. Hope it answers clearly the questions. Don't hesitate to post all the comments on the video or the blog post. Thanks for watching and see you very soon.